Welcome back to Let's Play Stories Untold Blind. I'm the RPG Chick, now beginning our fourth and final episode, the last session. In the last two episodes, we were playing someone named James Asian. Not sure who we were in the first episode, but well, this had to do with a house that was happy, and then all of a sudden the house was not so happy and it was very creepy. And then we found ourselves. And, chaos ensued. And then we found out something happened to our sister. Evidently there was a car crash or something. Something to that effect. And the lab conduct. We're examining an alien artifact. And basically it was a black box. We could tap into its memories. And yeah, that was that. And we ended up joining them or something. And basically, I think what ended up happening is we took over the lab, or escaped from it, either one. And then the station process, we were in Greenland, of all places, stationed out there monitoring for something. And apparently something, I'm guessing aliens, landed in the area. We had to restart generators, and then all hell broke loose. And at the end, someone told us to wake up. We need to follow the machines, something like that, and wake up. That's when they called us James and Mr. Asian. So now the last session. These stories are all connected in some way, even though they're separate stories. So I'm interested to see where this goes, how things develop. With the knowledge that we have. Do-do-do.
I think that's enough of that for now.
Oh, he stopped the intro. That's cool. I like that. I was watching that.
You're quite fond of this show, aren't you?
Oh, there's Greenland. Stories Untold. Futuro, computer. Number puzzles. These are all my stories.
Okay, come on. Let's get you down to the observation room.
The observation room? Oh, apparently I'm in a wheelchair.
This place must be starting to feel like home to you.
Hospital, that's sad.
Don't worry. Try and get you out of here eventually.
Eventually. Under stress.
Just in here.
Keep a healthy mind. That's very bright.
There's okay, are we through in the next room?
Deck.
Just relax, and we'll get started in a moment.
Okay, I have control again. I cannot read that.
Right, Mr. Asian, now are you ready?
James Asian.
Just hit record on the tape deck in front of you when you're ready.
What if I hit play instead? Hey, I didn't click that.
This is subject 12-19-86-23.
1986.
New session entry. We have myself, Dr. Alexander, leading, and in a room we have our patient, Mr. James Asian.
Right.
As we know, James has recently recovered from a two-week coma following his accident.
Oh.
In our last three sessions, James's attempts to recollect events of the accident seen him merging his memory with his imagination.
Hence the following stories preceding.
Have always ended in panic, and we've had to terminate the session abruptly. Let's try and do this one better, James. So when you're ready, let's bring this back. I know how difficult this must be, but you can do this. James, it's time to remember.
So if that's recording me...
Your mind. It's like a conscious black box.
Episode 2?
It can show you your memories. Look into it.
Yup. It's, again, it's the beacon on Eden Prime here. Just like in the lab process episode. Wires, symbols, glyphs, like in the second episode.
In your most recent episode, you recalled a false memory of a remote weather station.
Right.
You were isolated from the rest of the world, locked inside your coma. Mm. We interacted with you daily, encouraging you to wake.
At the voices at the end.
Your family would do number puzzles with you. Anything, really, to bring you back. People needed answers, James. Do you remember?
I get it.
I have another signal here for you, James. It's at 5610 FM. You can't miss it.
5610. So, okay. They were doing number puzzles with me, and I was figuring it out in my mind and putting it into my story. Dreams work very similarly, actually. At least mine do. I'll hear something outside, like a car alarm, and it'll become something else in the dream I'm having. Or it'll be me tripping a car alarm in my dream, or something like that. That's my number.
23.
23.
04. Type in the numbers, James. You gotta see this.
Huh.
This is 20F. 20F. 19, 86. 23. 04. Type in the numbers, James. You gotta see this.
Back to this. Report. This is a systems test. Traceback code is case sensitive. Confidential. Yup. Is it the same as before? Oh. Now we have Wilson Police Department. Road traffic accident report file. Well, we can zoom in on this. Empty whiskey. Alright. Number of vehicles, 2. Date, time of accident. 23-86. Accident location, Pleasant Hill Forest Road. 20F, fatal accident. That's the guy who was just talking, and he was on a ship, I think. James Asian. Whoops, too fast. Injured. Driver's street address, one-way view drive. Pewter Bridge. Wilson. I think that would be Kansas? There was a number on one of these codes for Kansas. We didn't figure it out. Did we go to Kansas on that? I think so. It was Canvas that we didn't go to. Date of birth, October 1st, 63. Vehicle station wagon, white. Plate number. Passenger 2, or passenger 1. Passenger 2. There was no passenger 2 in that car. Driver 2 information, Charles Hennings. Zoom in better, or focus better, but we can't. Solmi. Wilson. Date of birth, 1940. Sudan? Or Sedan? Blue. Passenger 1. Not revealed whether injured or deceased. Accident description. Arrived on scene to discover 2 cars that had been involved in a near head-on collision. Mr. Asian found lying down outside his vehicle with head injuries. An ambulance was immediately called. His passenger was trapped in the vehicle in critical condition from wounds sustained in the collision. That wasn't filled out, passenger. The driver of the blue sedan Mr. Hennings was found dead on arrival. It wasn't filled out, see? Not filled out at all. It was noticed that there was a strong smell of whiskey from the driver and an empty whiskey bottle on the passenger seat. From the second driver? Mr. Asian was questioned on scene. He described an oncoming blue sedan being clearly out of control. Is that a make of a car, sedan? Which he swerved to avoid. Mr. Asian's passenger was his sister. The driver of the blue sedan is an ex-police officer of 20 years. Wow. There's that name again, Daniel Alexander. Passenger 1 is crossed out, passenger. Oh, so he's the driver. Oh, and there's passenger 1. Got it. So he... deceased. I see it now. They're drivers, not passengers. Alright, let's zoom back out. Page intentionally left blank. Well, then this is report. And what do we need to do with it? Line 1. This is so we know what the hell. We realize what happened. So, which is line 1? Okay, yeah, game crashed. That was fun. Hope it doesn't happen again, because I have to go through all the cutscenes all over again. So maybe 20F, since it's circled, 20F fatal accident? Wait. Oh, it's circled. All the things we want are circled. Out of control are the other two lines, I think. 20F dash fatal accident. I had caps on, I guess. Yep. Oh, I didn't even mean to hit that. I meant to hit... well, that's okay. I'll have to double check this. 20F fatal accident. So empty whiskey, out of control are the other two lines. Control, baby. Analyzing file. Searching.
Find the signal, James.
Audio archive.
Listen to the voices.
Reporting officer.
You have to face it, James.
NS1.
Finally.
Officer Williams interview. 7000 FM. Don't crash on me now. 7000.
Not like him. At all. I've worked with Officer Hennings for 6 years and not once have we even talked about alcohol. Drunk driving.
Okay, we crashed again and I saw that if you bump the graphics quality down with the little launcher down to medium, that might help. Also said not to tab over. Of course, how can you play the game without tabbing over to see the microfiche or whatever, microfilm? I hit tab by mistake, so I'm used to tabbing down to lines like these, so I hit tab instead of enter. But hopefully we don't crash this time. That'd be great.
Find the signal, James. Listen to the voices. You have to face it, James. Finally.
7000 FM.
Not like him. At all. I've worked with Officer Hennings for 6 years and not once have we even talked about alcohol. Drunk driving. He was a father, a husband, he was fine. No way he caused this. It's him, this Haitian guy. He's got something to hide.
Light flickers on. A door slams shut, plunging you into darkness. Okay, we've made it this far. Okay. More wonky mouse look. This doesn't make sense to you. You step out into the hospital ward, only it seems abandoned. Your vision is blurry. Yes, it is. Oh, I can't do the zoom in. Time to quit. Help is here. You guys back there? Driving home, don't have that fifth pint. Hint, hint. First steps to recovery. Oh, that's weird looking. You tense up. Someone else is here. Myself? Locked? Got file cabinets. Don't like that very much. Keys? You grab the keys from the table. They weigh heavy in your hand. That's me, right? Turning. Nothing but a chase me, man. Kinda gets spooky, isn't it? Spooky! I don't like the spooky. Ward 4. Oh, like game 4. And like my patient number is 1298-8623, and we've got 04, which for the game. Chapter 4. Those look very old. Day room, pre-surgery. You've spent most waking moments in here. What? I can't walk around that? Ah, TV. Pre-surgery. You only caught a glimpse of the room. You guess that's why there is no detail here. Oh, I'm in my memory again? Okay. Another door you never opened. You don't know what was in there. I guess I was out here then. The waiting area is dark, but you feel a presence right behind you. I don't want to feel a presence right behind me. that was trying to open? Wait. That was a door opening sound. What? Locked. Someone breathes on your neck, standing over you. Negative. Negative. You feel dread in the pit of your stomach. Go to the light, Carol Ann.
Okay, we have a 22-year-old male just brought in from a vehicle collision. He was awake and mobile at the scene, but collapsed on arrival to the emergency ward.
There's that thing.
The other passengers died in the accident. I'm getting no pulse. Prepare for defib. Amp charge full to 10 and give me 100 joules.
There's all that equipment. So I must have saw that and put it in my dream.
Come on, 100 joules. Charge amp full to 10. Come on.
What do you want? 100 joules? I can't mess with that. Joules!
Can we get this on the screen, please?
Screen. Got green screen. Alright, 100 joules. I'm on camera here.
I can't see what I'm doing. Get this on the screen now.
One hundred joules. We want on this 10? I don't even see it moving. Oh, here we go. Clear!
Can't see what I'm doing. Get this on the screen now.
Here we go. What's my eye? All right, clear. No. Awaiting X-ray data.
Can't see what I'm doing. Get this on the screen now.
Alright, we're on screen. What do I do now? Turn it off. Ah, okay, clear.
Clear. No reaction from first stage. Let's try higher.
Sorry, I'm new at this.
200 joules. Keep the amp charged at 10.
Amp 10, 200 joules. Got it. Just watch my eye, will ya?
200 joules.
I know.
Keep the charge at 10. Let's go.
It's going up. Can I go? I can go faster. I stopped. Clear.
Clear. Okay, we have a reaction of some sort here, a weak signal. Let's keep going. Increase again. 360, charge full.
Come
on, 360, hurry.
It's going. Just have to fine-tune it here. Clear.
Clear. Well, would you look at that? Seems we have a pulse.
Happy birthday.
Rhythm is stable. We need to run an X-ray right away.
Got it. X-ray.
Where are we with that X-ray? Let's get it going now, please.
How do I do this again?
Looks like an intracerebral hemorrhage. We need to drain this now to relieve pressure. Prepare for trepanation. Switch on a drill, please.
Trepanation. Got it. I need to turn this off. I think it's off.
The drill, please.
It's on. That needs to be off. Does the monitor need to be off completely? Oh wait, that's off.
Can we get this on the screen, please?
My bad.
Mr. Ishin, you've made excellent progress. You're doing great. You need you to stay calm and try to relax.
Analyzing file. Oh my god.
We're going to attempt to alleviate some of this discomfort.
Well, that's where that comes from, that line. Ooh. That's what that meant, and I thought they were talking to somebody inside, which is actually an alien artifact, inside that chamber in episode 2. Was the house abandoned again? I'm back in my first memory. Or first false memory. Oh, it's on fire. I don't know why you need a modem to play it. Not only is tonight New Year's Eve, but tomorrow you leave on a 6-month trip abroad with friends. Mom, Dad, and your sister Jennifer have decided to throw a party to celebrate it all. The house is full. You're in the living room, and as usual, you don't recognize a soul. Oh, I'm all caps. Look. Jennifer. Sorry, I don't know what you're looking at. Look around. The room is full of chatty strangers, mostly friends of Mom and Dad. There's a door to the hall. Look at strangers. All friends of Mom and Dad. The youngest is probably twice your age. Okay. Exit? You push through the crowd into the hallway. The hallway is as welcoming as ever, only this time the folks have put a great big banner up across the main wall. Half-finished drinks are abandoned on almost every horizontal surface. Stairs lead up, although the party is firmly downstairs. Banner. Bon voyage, James. Finally, not the family disappointment. Drinks. Bottles of beer and half-drunk glasses of wine. Same. Hall? Same as ever. Stairs, door to the living room, and door to the kitchen. I was in the living room. Go to kitchen. I never made it inside that utility closet. They say all the best parties are in the kitchen. The kitchen is full of people and loud. There are drinks and food on the table, and the party is in full swing. Dad has cooked a hog roast, which sits proudly on the table, although no one is eating it. Roast looks great. People. Don't know what you're looking at. Look at food. That's in your description. Look at drinks. I don't recognize. Look at table. Look at door. The utility room door is unlocked. That's odd. open door. Just as you are about to head inside the utility room, Jen places her hand on your hug. You're going to miss each other. You thank her for the party. She asks if you are enjoying the party. Lie and say yes. You tell her it's great, even though you don't really know anyone. She tells you to enjoy it anyway and to loosen up. She asks you to get her a drink. Get drink. You pour Jen a drink, and one for yourself, too. There's never an awkward silence with Jennifer. She always has a question. She asks if you have everything sorted for the big trip. Yes. You tell her yes, that you have packed everything with plenty of room to spare. Another hug. Your family have really gone out of their way to make this trip happen for you. It might be what you need to get some perspective and not bleep up so much. She's going to miss you. You are going to miss her. She walks away. Jen has disappeared into the crowd. You are left standing, nodding and smiling at the approving faces. There's so much to do for this move. Can't mess it up. But first, a drink. Drink. You pour and down another drink. Anything to move the night along. Open door. You open the door and peer in. You're never allowed in here normally. This is where Dad keeps his fine wines and whiskeys. Ceiling to floor racks. A collector. Although he does usually drink them too. There's a bottle with a ribbon around it and a card. I don't know if I'm supposed to go upstairs first or go in here first or if it doesn't matter. Racks, some seriously expensive and old wines. Proper something tastes. Well, that means. Whiskey. Dad got you into whiskeys. No cheap rubbish here. The bottle. And there's a card. It's a gift from Dad, I think. There is a card next to it. Get bottle. You pick up the whiskey and the card. It's your dad's handwriting. Son, we're so proud of you and everything you've achieved. You've earned this. It's a bottle of a 25-year-old double malt. You shouldn't really, but you have to try it. With your whiskey in hand, you take in the room around you. There must be hundreds, no thousands of pounds worth of drink in here. You really must thank your dad for the whiskey. I'm picking it up again. Right. Yep. Okay. Anything else? Look around. There are racks of fine wines in the door to the kitchen. Remember that note that kept changing? Read note. It's that. I wish I could, speed this along. I tried the thing three times. Exit. You head back into the kitchen, clutching your new best friend. You stumble out of the utility room and back into the kitchen. That is one strong whiskey. You take another swig and give the thumbs up to Dad across the table. He nods and winks. Look at Dad. He's young looking for his age. Hopefully you'll have the same luck. I don't suppose Mom is here? Don't know what you're looking at. You can't see Jen, so you must have moved through to the hall. Alright. You go back out to the hallway. A few bumps and laughs on the way through and you make it to the hall. You stop dead in your tracks. It's Jen, covered in blood. Okay, really must be going now. Go upstairs. She's staring straight at you. No one else notices. I'm gonna go in the living room. Blood is dripping down her face. It's mixing with tears. What if I type wait? And it was like, keep saying wait. I'm sorry, I don't understand. Talk to Jen. I don't understand. Look at Jen. I don't understand. Exit. Dead girl. Hello?
I'm sorry, I don't understand.
I don't understand.
We tried our best, Mrs. Ashen, but her injuries were too severe.
Aww. No, I don't understand. I was just talking to her.
I'm afraid Jennifer passed away before we could get to her in surgery. We did the best we could. I'm so sorry.
Where is she? Let me see her.
Please, Mrs. Ashen, take a seat.
I don't want to take a seat. Let me talk to her. Now.
I'll arrange for you to see her. In the meantime, James is in recovery. He's stable for now.
I don't want to see him.